About 4 million Americans have been infected with COVID-19. At least 140,000 have died, while many more have recovered. Now that we're months into the pandemic, we're learning more about what it means to treat and recover from the disease. Hi, I'm Eric Hamilton, a science writer at UW-Madison, and this is Badger Talks. Today, we're speaking with Jeff Pothof, Chief Quality Officer for UW Health and a Professor of Emergency Medicine at the UW School of Medicine and Public Health, about what we've learned about treating and recovering from COVID-19. Jeff, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Eric.
So, Jeff, I'm wondering, now that doctors have had more experience with the disease, what have they learned about treating the most seriously ill patients in the hospital?
Yeah, so as we've had more experience treating patients, we begin to figure out what works, what doesn't work. And as I'm sure you realize, there were all kinds of medications being touted and different strategies to care for these patients. You know, a few that we found that are pretty effective, one would be remdesivir. Remdesivir is an antiviral that we know more than likely, very likely, has benefit for those more sick patients. And that's something that we've been using to treat very sick patients with COVID-19 with success. I think the other thing you'll hear about is this technique called proning, this idea that we flip people over on their stomachs when they're having a difficult time breathing. And that's proving to be a fairly successful strategy as we treat COVID-19 patients. You know, the last thing that I think has really good evidence behind it is the use of dexamethasone in those individuals with severe respiratory misfunction. You know, we knew that dexamethasone worked well in individuals who had ARDS, a similar disease pathology as to what we see in COVID-19. And now we've had research studies that confirm that indeed it does provide benefit to those patients. So as we've gained more experience, we've gotten better at treating patients with COVID-19.
That's great to hear that we're learning more about how to handle it. But I also understand that most patients have a more mild or moderate case that might not bring them to the hospital. What's their experience with this disease typically like, and what does their recovery usually look like?
Yeah, you can imagine there's a range of experiences, but when we talk about individuals who've got more mild disease, maybe defined by not requiring hospitalization, you know, frequently the things that we hear most from those patients is they have severe fatigue. So they get really tired. They find it difficult to kind of do the things that they want to do. And they'll complain of either shortness of breath or just a real pressure in their chest that can be really uncomfortable. For the most part, those patients are treated with just over-the-counter medications, ibuprofen and Tylenol if you're having aches and pains, maybe some decongestants if you're feeling, you know, stuffed up. And the real medicine for those people is actually time. It takes time for the virus to work itself out. Now, for some people, that could be 10 days, 14 days of, you know, feeling unwell, letting those fevers go away. You know, for other people, we're hearing that their symptoms seem to prolong. They seem to have symptoms that get a little bit better. And then a couple weeks later, they just continue to feel, you know, more fatigue, maybe a little bit more shortness of breath. And for some of these people, this becomes more of a long-term problem of trying to get better from these symptoms. Whereas, you know, other people sometimes have their symptoms for 2 weeks and then are kind of back to normal.
Yeah, I wanted to ask about that. Do we know how common these longer-term health effects might be for people who've are no longer actively infected, and what might be behind those lingering effects?
Yeah, I would say this is still an area of active research. So we do know, and we're hearing more reports, especially from overseas, of a large percentage of patients who had either moderate or more severe COVID-19. They're taking a long time to recover. Some studies look at patients who are taking, you know, more than 60 days to recover. And even at that 60-day point, are still having symptoms. Now, you know, we don't know the exact reason. We think it could be related to the immune system's response, to tissues being damaged, needing time to heal. But I think moreover, you know, we've only been dealing with COVID for, you know, 7-8 months right now. In the terms of, you know, long-term effects, that's still a very short period of time. I think what we'll need to see is over the next 1 to 2 years, what are those true long-term implications of having COVID-19, and are there side effects or symptoms that may persist for a very long time in some patients?
Sure. Sounds like we'll have to keep an eye on it. And then this might be the million-dollar question is, do we now know whether or not infection with COVID-19 helps protect against reinfection in the future? And if so, how long that kind of immunity might last?
Yeah, I don't think there's any of us that are willing to bet our life savings in Vegas on it right now. But of the studies that we're seeing and the data that we're seeing, it's looking promising. It's looking promising that if you're infected with COVID-19, there will be a period of time, and we're not sure how long yet, that you may have immunity or may have some ability to combat reinfection. You know, we're learning about COVID-19 as we're experiencing it. So we're not 100% sure of this yet, but it's looking promising. If we look at other viruses like COVID-19, so the original SARS virus, we did see immunity that was pretty good for about 6 months, but then over the course of 2 years waned. And it's just too early to tell if immunity to COVID-19 will last for a month, 2 months, longer, or if it will rapidly go away and we might still be susceptible. So fingers crossed that that immunity holds, but we're not quite sure yet.
Yeah, fingers crossed for sure. Well, Jeff, thank you so much for joining us.
You bet, anytime.
For more information, you can go to covid19.impact.wisc.edu. And if you have questions, comments, or suggestions for us, you can email us at covid19update@uc.wisc.edu. I'm Eric Hamilton, and this is Badger Talks.